This group, carrying U.S. and Israeli flags, came to support Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu's right to speak. Joyce and Bernard Sachs of Springfield, Virginia, have children and grandchildren living in Israel.
When you tuck your children in at night, ask yourself what you have done to make America safe and to stand up for America's only ally in the Middle East, Israel.
A counter-demonstration was held about a block away. They carried signs saying, Netanyahu, go home, you don't represent Jews or Judaism.
Netanyahu's speech today here, this warmongering against Iran, and this insulting behavior against our president.
At one point, protesters supporting Netanyahu objected to the message of the anti-Netanyahu group.
You guys are a bunch of idiots.
Our Jewish people.
Buddy.
I lived in Israel 13 years.
After breaking up the argument, which turned heated, U.S. Capitol Police took up positions in front of the protesters.
All of this was going on while Netanyahu addressed Congress. Afterwards, CARE, the Council on American-Islamic Relations, said Israel should not be allowed to dictate U.S. policy on Iran.
Just keep in mind that Israel is a nuclear power, and Israel is posing threat to its neighboring countries.
Netanyahu's speech was applauded by the Jewish Community Relations Council of Greater Washington, representing local synagogues and schools.
He drew pictures in people's minds about the danger of a nuclear Iran in stark terms, which I think is going to leave an everlasting impression for many people.
The speech led to some spirited debate, but in the end, the demonstrators disbanded peacefully. On Capitol Hill, Chris Gordon, News 4.